Heyo, we're back. Yeah. So this is gonna be a bit of a different episode. I'm gonna go through some statistics and history and stuff like that. And I'm not sure if I'll get any real playing done. I'm just gonna try to catch myself up. I haven't played since Sunday, I think. So it's been a few days and I've been away. I have actually been hereabouts for 2 days now. So finally just got back today. Delayed airplane and everything. Really, really annoying. Anyway, enough about me. So far in this Let's Play, we've been playing as a Norwegian Duke, as most of you know. Things have been going okay. I had a request to have a look through some of the different map modes to have a look around. I'm going to do that in a second. Right now, I'm the Duke of Trøndelag. I am the Duke of Munster, I'm the Duke of Jämtland, and I'm the Duke of Leinster. Then we have a few counties, mostly on the Norwegian west coast, and in addition to that this one, Ångermanland in Sweden, in modern day Sweden rather. It's never been part of Sweden in this Let's Play, I think. So, yeah. No, Norwegian. Yeah. Even the people living here are Norwegian. So, go figure. These people are Swedish, though. So, Västerbotten, still Swedish. Otherwise, there are a lot of Laps or Sami people living around here. So, there's that. I'm currently on my third Duke. I think the fourth Duke, yeah. We have Marcus the First, who was then succeeded by Helga the First, who reigned for a fairly short time, I believe. And he was then succeeded by Helga the Second, who was then again succeeded by Trond the First. So if we take a look at the Duchy of Trøndelag and see its history, we'll see that Magnus the First of Trøndelag ruled for a fairly short time. I think he is... Yeah. I believe he is the brother of... Yeah, King Harald. Yeah, he held... Ooh, he died of smallpox. Well, anyway, he ruled for about 9 months, then I took over. Ruled for quite a long time, about 50 years almost. Then his son took over and ruled for 30 years. And then it was a comparatively short reign from Duke Helga II till Duke Trond I, only about 11 years between them, something like that. So yeah, the Bergheim family is doing okay for itself. Its family tree is getting rather large. Let's have a look. Most of the bloodlines have been shortish. Finally lost control of Jakub's bloodline. Snofrid was never really part of it. Frenna, now this was a cursed bloodline. I think they're still around though. Yeah, look, Frenna the Second. He's even a count of Lapland, who's inherited from Ulvia. So there's still Frenner around. He has a son. Could inherit. He has two sons. He's married exotically. So, let's see. Yep. Fairly recently, too. There's some Ynglings. Jorunn was married off to the Ynglings, who are the Norwegian kings, of course. So she is... Countess of Oppland. Ah, yes. Married to the Count of Oppland. Oh, interesting. Other than that, yeah, Margrethe is kept in the family as well. Gotten three sons, so that should keep the bloodline strong. So Frenner, the Frenner bloodline is actually doing fairly well. Let's see. Well, I say that, of course, but then, well, Count of Leinster, so yeah, they're still actually around. gonna die out anytime soon. Even Bjorn had... Well, he had a son who actually inherited his... Yep. A young Count of Kula. Who has a cousin. That's a niece, isn't it? Yeah, that's his niece. Oh, and we've kept her in the family, and she decided to have three sons. So, did I say the Fianna line was cursed? That is completely ass backwards. They're fine. They're doing very well. They represent one of the larger parts of the family, I think. There is a lot of stuff going on here. And they're also heavily married into the Yingling family, of course, so this might actually prove to be a politically significant part of the family. Lucas, on the other hand, let's see, how did he do? Well, yep, he's got a count there, Lucas again, with a count. I wonder who inherited that one. Who is the current Count of Ariel? That's a good question. Okay, it turned to this guy and then went down here, so yeah. And he has... Yep, she's not interesting, and she... Ooh! Both Orkneyjar and Yngling. Interesting. So yeah, these bloodlines should be fairly secure. So yeah, Lucas, you're doing fine as well. Helga, of course, this is still the ruling branch of the family. And Trun, in turn... had an elder son. This is a legitimized bastard, I think. Pretty sure that's a legitimized bastard. Yeah, that's probably why he loves me and why everybody else might... Yeah, well, they're still happy. That's good. That's good. So, another snowflake. And, of course, Helgi's daughter Ragna, who is the queen of the Byzantine Empire. Good for her. My nephew is... Prince. Is that her? Yeah. Thought she had more than two children. Let's just have a quick look at that. Because I'm curious. Well, apparently, only two children. Not childbearing age yet, or still rather. 17. This girl. Her mother seems to be dead. Wonder what killed her. Natural death. Oh, at the age of 38. Quite recently, actually. Oh well. So, is this guy in line? Yeah, he's very much in line. So this is the upcoming heir to the Byzantine Empire. Wonder if Well, looky there. He's actually going to say yes to that. That's amazing. There is 131 prestige in it for me if I do that. But I'm a bit worried about them being a bit closely related, because that's my daughter, so that's her, and that's him. They're cousins. They're first cousins at that, so... No, Tempting as those 200 and something are, and it matters not at all to me if they're children are inbred, actually. I'm not going to do that. And he will not accept just some random courtier. It's not even exactly a random courtier, that's my niece. So no. No, it's basically... my daughter or nothing, I think. Yep, he'll accept that. That is interesting, though. Well, food for thought. Anyway, so the Helga line is doing fine. Gabriel, original Gabriel. Yeah, should probably be some titles here somewhere. Oh, she's dead. It's my aunt, isn't it? Yep, this is my bloodline, or my cousins. Oh my god, there's a total of 152 living members. Oh my god. So yeah, this clan is getting huge. And all this because Marcus was a fertile man. Also, his children have been as well. Dead. I get kind of curious, what is she? She looks like she has a fancy title. Yeah, she's the Queen of Sicily. That's cool. She's ambitious. She does not like me a lot, though. Nope, so there's that. Yeah, because this is the Helga line, and Thorgan, yep, still around. It's dead. Cecilia, Rangwall, yep, you're not... Well, you're getting kind of old. Are you married? No, you're not. Well, maybe we should arrange for that. Let's take a quick look, see if we can find someone suitable. Preferably somebody landed. You want to run off and marry an... Do I need you? You're possessed. That'll be fine. Get out of here. Possessed Crusaders, that's... We don't need that lying around. So yeah, that's him gone. And she's already out. Maybe he can have some children. Redeem his bloodline a bit. You're doing fine on your own. Although that's a lot of daughters, isn't it? Let's just see if we can get a matrilineal. Arrange betrothal. And see if anybody will take it. Some old geezers are willing to do that. Of course they are. How old is she? Oh no, I can't do that to her. Not yet, anyway. If I remember later, I'll do it. Probably won't. So yeah, 20 years old. Still a chance for you. So you were dead end, weren't you? Yep, you are. So that's Helga. Then there's Alec. Any of his children still around? Yeah. They are. Needs to get married, though, if it's gonna be any hope for him. Let's see. Arrange marriage. Not exactly the pick of the litter, is it? Maybe a lot of time to have one kid. Need to reduce my court anyway, so I might as well get rid of some people. Anywho. Yeah. Sean. Now he's one of those people who rebelled, isn't he? Anyway, there's still some Alec blood around. These guys stand a good chance. Wonder where they are. They are in... I have no idea what that even means. That's probably somewhere in Ireland. Yeah. Then there's Sulvai. Anybody still around from this bloodline? Does not look like it. Wow, they all married Blixens. That's interesting. Ah, well, there is guys. Wonder where they are. They are in Castile. Oh yeah. This is Ongermanland. Okay, no, that was not who I thought she was. And this one, Vestlanda. Okay, how the hell did these people end up in Castile? Oh, it matters not. Gabriel, my original failure, 72-year-old. Yeah, you're the woman I was thinking about. You're the queen of Castilia. And this is the... Oh my. Not this guy now? He is remotely related to me. Very remotely. Is he willing to marry back into my bloodline? Nope. Well, suit yourself, young man. Yeah, so there is no one left of Gabriel's bloodline. It's kind of a shame. He was a genius after all, and he did serve me well in the end. Huh. Oh, well, memories. Anyway, that was the current state of the bloodline. If anybody have any specific questions they want answered, feel free to post them in comments and I'll take a look at them. So let me just check something. We're nearing the 20-minute mark, I think. Yep. So I'm gonna just quickly go over the statistics. This is the diplomatic relations. So I'd say cold. Oh yeah, I have poor alliances with all these things, don't I? Yeah. So these people should be able to. Am I working on that? Where are you, my friend? Oh, you're working on Holstein. Or Holsten, rather. If I could get a casus belli, that would be sweet, because these are some nice holdings. And should be a fairly... yeah, account, I don't care about that. Yep, should be an easy battle. The realm power is pitiful. So yeah, I should be able to take them down easy. Religions. Let's see, where are we? Catholic faith is doing fine, I believe. I even ousted Norse people from Scandinavia as well. From Sweden. Orthodoxy is doing okay. Haven't gotten a foot all up here, but they are. And there's one Catholic province in the middle of Russia. Or Poland. I don't know. Culture-wise, Lapish and Finnish. And then there's a Norwegian enclave right here. Some more Finnish, Danish, Norwegian. North Germanic, yeah. And then of course, I think Norwegian culture might actually be advancing in Ireland and England. That's interesting. German, Frankish, Andalusian, Italian. Greek seems to be doing well. Russian is doing okay. Kume. Well, hope that answered people's questions. Economy-wise, oh my god, that's terrible. Terrible news, everyone. One bright spot in all of this. Oh, yeah, man, land! De jure, duchies. My big old trend lag. Norrland, of course. Jämtland. Ostland, Westland. I really want to grab Westland. That's my next goal, I think. Apart from this. None of the de jure kingdoms. Yeah. Not so sure about that. Finland is huge, though. There will be some drift here, I think, fairly soon. I have a strong suspicion that some of these are slowly but surely drifting into Norwegian hands. Should be some drift anyway. Anywhere I can see that? Because that would be interesting to see how long it would take. Being incorporated de jure into Sultanate of Scotland? How the hell is this becoming a sultanate? That makes absolutely no sense to me. Oh well. Sultanate of Scotland? Really? Who's the King of Scotland these days? Does this have anything to do with the fact that... Hang on. There is no king in Scotland. But there is a Scottish king in Jerusalem. No, it's oh my. That's a strange look for the mirror. I somehow get the feeling that as an independent realm, this thing spent some time under the Israeli or the Jerusalem throne, and because the Jerusalem throne is now a sultanate, then that's why. Somebody explain it to me, but because I certainly can't really understand it. There's some drift here. Duchy of Vestjutland being incorporated de jure into the Kingdom of Norway. Yeah. There is drift here. This isn't drifting. Not sure why. Is it because there's no duchy here? That's probably why, isn't it? And that's probably why this is drifting. Yep. So if I created this duchy here, then that would start drifting as well. I see. Cool. Game mechanic. De jure empires. Scandinavia. The goal of this let's play. Become the emperor of Scandinavia. Let's see if I can do it. I should probably get a move on. Revolt risk is fine. There's hardly any. Slight revolt risk here, but nothing to worry about. Oh. Well, he stands still ruling EU. Then there's the dynasty, the dynasties. Yngling, isn't that just peachy? The Dukas. Nice. Pialbu, that seems wrong somehow. The opinions. Well, I don't like you guys either. This guy hates my guts. Hardly surprising. Not long since I occupied the little brat. Yeah, usurped his title. I'm a foreigner. I have his title. I declared war on him. Can't say I blame him not for not liking me. I want to arrange a marriage with him. Okay. Ooh, does that tell me how everybody feels about him? Yeah, it does, doesn't it? Ah. Interesting. Okay, my direct vassals. The direct vassals of Trøndelag are most of Norway and the whole of Ireland. Yeah. So there's that. Then there's the family trades, and I don't care about that. So that was the summation of the state of the Let's Play so far. So a little bit over time, but that doesn't really matter. I'm gonna check one quick thing before I quit, and that is the state of my king. I can declare independence or I can depose him. That would install Duke Trond the First of Trøndelag. Install my favorite heir. So that would be me. I can actually rise up. Hehehehehehehe. 39,000 troops. And now I've got 11,000. Wonder if I could get anybody to join me in that war. Well, we shall have a look at that. And anybody have any opinions about whether or not I should declare war? Also, if anybody wants to save game, just let me know and I'll post it so you guys can download it and have a look if you want. Anyway, that's it for this episode. I hope you enjoyed it. This was the summation episode. I'll be careful to put a note in it so that people don't watch this and get bored to tears because I'm not doing anything. Oh my god. Anyway, I'll see you around, so cheers!